grateful to Tim Decker, who's behind the camera here, helping me out today. We're trying to figure out technology, and we are still struggling with a lot of these things, but hopefully this will work for this evening. I was going to give you a reflection today, and I'm going to change that because I have some announcements. And the first one being is tomorrow, Father Ryan will be here with me, and he will celebrate Mass at 10 o'clock, and we hope to live stream that event. So instead of giving you a reflection this afternoon, I'll save that for tomorrow for a homily, and we'll insert it into the Mass. So we're going to skip the reflection this evening, but still would like to talk to all my friends here at Prince of Peace and everyone else who might be joining in. And I have some notes here, so let me start by looking at what I've got here. First of all, I think on behalf of Father Ryan, Deacon Bill, Deacon Dennis, and our whole staff here, we miss everyone. It's awfully empty and lonely around here without everybody. I miss your smiles. I miss your camaraderie. I miss your hugs, and I certainly miss the high fives that I used to get. So we're praying together as a parish family, and we're praying as a world right now that an end can come to this, not in our time, but in God's perfect time. So if that may be 2 weeks or a month or 2 months or whatever that case may be, that we can have an end to this in God's perfect time. We are a community, we are a family, and I'm hoping that this time of separation will bring us together, that people won't wander away, that we'll actually come closer together as a family. So this is one of the ways we're going to try to do this, and hopefully stay in touch more in the future this way. So as I mentioned, tomorrow we'll live stream Mass, and hopefully that'll begin at 10 o'clock or somewhere right around there. We'll see how it goes, and if it works well, then we will go forward and try to do Mass during the week, Mass or two during the week, and then on the weekends as well. And then especially when we get to Holy Week, we'll try to live stream everything. And I know you can go to other parishes or the cathedral for live stream Mass, but I had a lot of people say to me, I want to see my own church. I want to see my own worship space. So we're going to try to do that for you, that we can help you feel like you're still here, and we can still be a family, even though we're separated. So let me give you some other announcements here. We are, first of all, in the office, very busy. You would think there's nothing to do, but we all have a lot of stuff to do. We're trying to be creative in terms of staying in touch with you. By directive of the diocese, we cannot cut back anybody's hours or lay anybody off. So we are keeping our staff the way it is, working their own hours. We have a couple of people who are working remotely.
I have to speak up.
Are working remotely, and it's working out fine. So we do have flexibility there, but everybody is working their jobs and helping out where they can in other areas as well. So we're not just doing what we were doing before. We're all kind of crossing over and helping each other. Based on that, let me just give you a couple of thoughts that I have here. First of all, I know we sent out the in the bulletin a few weeks ago, we had the flyer on our logo wear that you see here. I had to wear this today, even though I wear it all the time. Our Prince of Peace logo wear that's actually out at Valley Apparel and Promotions. So if you go to valleyadvertise.com, you'll be able to, and you go under the company pride drop-down box, you'll see Prince of Peace, and there's a couple of pages of items that you can purchase that have our logo on it. We don't benefit from this at all as a parish. discounts, so whatever you are paying is the best price that we can give you. You can still order things there, and you can actually go pick them up or have them mailed to you. So whatever you would prefer. But I would hope that you would want to show your pride for your lunch by purchasing local wear. Actually, had some sweatpants made here so you can see these real quick. I'm really dressed up for you today. Sweatpants, tennis shoes, but you can go to our website there, and hopefully there's something that you'll purchase. That there's a logo wear for children as well, so it's not just for adults. There's specific things for females, so hopefully there's something there that you can find that will help you show your parish pride. I wouldn't have announcements, but they wouldn't be complete without talking about the bishop's appeal. We are now at $59,435, which is 84% of our financial goal, so we're doing very well there. We have 324 gifts, so 324 different parishioners, registered members have donated, and that's 21% of our registered members. We have 1,550 registered members, so we are abiding pretty much by the 80-20 rule. 80% of the money is coming from 20% of our people. If we could get to 500 members that would contribute, if people gave $7 a month, and you can contribute monthly to the bishop's appeal over a 12-month period, we will definitely hit our goal and probably surpass it. So I'm hoping that we can do this during this downtime. We can hit this bishop's appeal goal and not have to worry about it going forward into the summer when we get back together again. So please, please, if you haven't donated, we have envelopes here. I think you might have actually received another mailer from the diocese this week. If you haven't, we do have envelopes here, and we can help you there as well. The other financial issue that we have is because nobody is coming to Mass, even last week our attendance was way down, our weekly contributions are suffering tremendously, and we still have the same expenses every week. So we do need your help. This is your parish, not mine, not anybody who works on the staff. This is your parish. We need to pay the light bill. We need to pay the utility bill, salaries for people, just a lot of ongoing things here. And so we need your help. And I think for a lot of people, it'll be, well, I don't have to donate right now. But more than ever, we need your help right now because everybody is not coming to Mass. So we do have ways to contribute. You can go on our website and you can ACH. You could have it taken out of your checking account automatically. A contribution every week or 2 weeks or monthly, whatever you would prefer. You can, we have a box when you walk in the door here that you can drop contributions in. So I have my envelope here that I'm going to put in right after this little talk. You can also just call us and tell us that you'd like to make a contribution, and we can take information down. That might be the most difficult thing, but we do have a Dropbox here and ACH, and we're also trying to develop an online giving on our website. So hopefully we can get to that fairly quick. That is my fault for not getting on that sooner, but hopefully we'll get that set up in the next few weeks and we can get going there as well. But that is critical for us right now. We're suffering financially. We are going to do some maintenance work around here. We are going to strip the floor in the fellowship hall and re-wax it so it'll be clean. We are going to clean all the carpets, and we're going to clean all of the seats here in the church as well. So we're going to do a lot of maintenance work while we are, in essence, shut down, to try to make things nicer so that when we do come back together, it'll be nice, fresh church for everybody. And it's easy for us to do this now. It's just going to cost us money that's not budgeted, so we'll need your help in that regard as well, too. We are still going to be open every day from 8 to 4. So
As long as you don't have more than 10 people here, you're welcome here. If we have 10, if you count more than 10, or 10 or more, 10 or less, or 10, I should say, you'll have to wait out in the gathering space until once somebody leaves. We haven't had that issue so far. We usually have 2, 3, 4 at the most, but we can get up to 10 here without having issues. And certainly this is a big enough place that we can congregate here, 10 people, and not have a problem with social distancing. We would prefer that you sit in the middle pews. We're gonna try to clean the side pews and then rope them off so that they stay sanitized. We do sanitize the pews here every day. The materials that you use, we have Stations of the Cross materials. We have rosaries that you can actually take. But anything that you touch there, we will sanitize daily. We have a prayer board that's in the gathering, in the fellowship hall. So you walk in there, if you use a pen, there's actually a spot to put a used pen so that we'll re-sanitize that. So we're trying to do the best we can to make sure that everybody stays safe if they do come here. But this is difficult. This is a very, very difficult time for all of us. And the best thing that we can all do is to pray. We've been putting a daily prayer on our website, and we will continue to do that. But we have a lot of time for prayer. And there is one thing I do love about this place is that it is so Christ present. I can feel Christ's presence here every time I'm here just praying alone. So I invite you to come here during the day. Spend a little time with Jesus. Pray to him that this crisis can end soon. Pray for your families. Pray for this family, that we can stay together, that we won't fall apart, and that when the time comes where we can get back together, we can all be here and celebrate and appreciate even more the fact that we'll have the Mass again, the fact that we'll have the friendship and time together that we all miss so dearly. I know I miss it so much. So that's all I have for announcements right now. Tomorrow at 10, hopefully we'll be live streaming on Facebook, and we'll put this on our website as well right after, so that for people who didn't see it, they'll be able to watch it there, whatever they would prefer. Same thing with the Mass tomorrow. We'll live stream it on Facebook, and then we'll have it on our website after, shortly thereafter, and if people missed it, they can watch it later. If you do have questions, you can call our office. Please call us and let us know what's on your mind, and we'll try to help any way that we can. If you're having problems, struggles with food or whatever, let us know, and we're going to try to get people together to help as well. So till tomorrow when we see you again, may God bless you, bless your families. Please pray for us here as we pray for you. God bless.